Welcome to this lecture on air quality in cities. I will start by addressing the question, what is air pollution? Many cities worldwide suffer from serious air quality problems, which have received increasing attention in the past decade. Urbanization processes often lead to air quality problems as population growth comes with increased emissions related to transport, energy use, industry, and processes like indoor cooking. These human activities severely degrade the quality of the air, a process generally called air pollution. And cities are important air pollution hotspots because pollution from large economic activity results in the exposure of many individuals to poor air quality. Here, it is important to understand that breathing polluted air leads to health problems, mostly related to lung and heart diseases. Now, what substances are we talking about? Two classes of compounds are considered when air quality is discussed. First, there are the gas phase air pollutants. These pollutants include carbon monoxide, released upon incomplete combustion of fuel, and nitrogen oxides, compounds released by traffic and, for instance, the use of biofuel. Other gas phase pollutants, like the aggressive form of oxygen, ozone, are formed in the atmosphere by chemical reactions that are driven by sunlight. For this reason, this kind of air pollution is commonly called photochemical smog. A second group of air pollutants that received considerable attention by scientific research in the recent years is in the form of small particulates that float in the air, called particulate matter, or PM. Depending on the size of the particulates, these are called PM2.5, PM10, and TSP, total suspended matter. Without going into detail, particulate matter may contain a wide variety of both natural and man-made substances, such as sea salt, black carbon, and dust. Speaking of air quality in cities, there are large differences between cities when it comes to air pollution concentrations and the factors that drive air pollution problems. In this video, I will focus on the cities of Amsterdam, Beijing, and Kampala to illustrate the diversity of urban air pollution. If we start with Amsterdam, we see in this figure, showing in blue 1 year of ozone measurements, that air pollution is episodic in nature, linked to the weather conditions. In the windy sea climate, with transport from the North Sea, air quality is mostly good, with the exception of traffic-dominated street canyons. However, during hot and sunny summer conditions, regional photochemical smog may form, with high levels of ozone. And especially in wintertime, with quiet weather conditions, particulate matter emitted by traffic and industry tends to accumulate. And various limit values indicated by the horizontal lines may be exceeded. Beijing in China has a pronounced land climate and often has poor air quality with very high levels of PM2.5, as shown by the blue symbols in this figure. Although these high levels are primarily caused by high pollutant emissions, weather and geographical position of the city also play an important role. In wintertime, mixing of the atmosphere is strongly suppressed under the cold winter conditions with little heating by the sun, leading to accumulation of air pollution close to the surface. Also, surrounding mountains lead to trapping of air pollution in the Beijing area, a phenomenon that also occurs in cities like Athens and Mexico City. A last factor influencing Beijing air quality is transport of dust from dry areas in the west, or more generally, atmospheric transport of air pollution from other polluted cities in China. Now let's move to the East African city Kampala. Here, measurements of air quality are scarce. Tropical sub-Saharan cities in Africa have distinct dry and wet seasons. If we compare available measurements from the dry season in Kampala, here shown as the green bar, to the Beijing PM2.5 concentrations, we see comparable high pollution levels. This is not only caused by highly polluting traffic, but also by resuspension of dust from unpaved roads. Additionally, seasonal biomass burning is widespread in Africa and releases large quantities of air pollution. Finally, air quality in Kampala is affected by the use of less advanced technologies in industrial processes and domestic consumption of energy for cooking and air conditioning. Now, what about the roles of NGOs, governments, and citizens? The World Health Organization has defined air quality guidelines for the various atmospheric pollutants. When the atmospheric concentrations remain below these guidelines, the health impact of air pollution remains limited. However, due to their variety, measuring air pollutants is difficult. Citizens therefore have to rely on scientists and governments to provide reliable information. Scientists and policymakers are therefore the main responsible actors behind air quality. This information, however, is often difficult to interpret since various air quality standards are used in different parts of the world. With increasing awareness of air quality effects on human health and the large impact of air pollution on the daily life of citizens worldwide, this situation is clearly in need of improvement. Citizens could become co-creators for the generation, interpretation, and use of air quality data in their cities and neighborhoods. In conclusion, due to differences in climate, infrastructure, technology, and human activity, air quality dynamics varies widely among cities around the world. By examining the air quality situation in Amsterdam, Beijing, and Kampala, and considering possibilities for co-creation of air quality data, we aim to show how citizens can help to improve the air quality in their city.